Ravens fans, help us get to 3,000 subs. Stay up to date on the latest Ravens news and rumors. So all you got to do, underneath the video, click that sub button, turn on those notifications, because the more subs we get, the more videos y'all get. Mitchell Renz from Chat Sports, and coming up here on today's show, we are going to go through the complete, and I mean the complete list of all the 2022 free agents of the Baltimore Ravens. Now, there's quite a bit, so sit down, get some popcorn, maybe go grab a soda because you might be here for a little while. Now, on some of the bigger name guys, that's kind of how we structured this video in terms of the bigger name dudes in the beginning, some of the smaller name guys at the end, but you know what? We wanted to give you every single name. Calais Campbell, Brandon Williams, Sammy Watkins, Patrick Ricard, and then Jimmy Smith. These are some of your unrestricted free agents. Also, you're going to see UFA, which means unrestricted. We'll also break down what an EFA is, essentially. But Calais Campbell, I know that he's getting up there in age, but this just continues to be one of the best defensive interior defensive linemen in the National Football League. Just a mountain of a man at 6'8", 300 pounds. He had 49 tackles, 1.5 sacks, 5 tackles for loss. Sure, he still isn't quite what he used to be, and the fact that he is contemplating retirement, if I was Campbell and I was his team, if I'm like, all right, if I believe that we can come back and chase a title, then I would end up coming back. The next player we're going to talk about here is Brandon Williams, which is also very, you know, similar to Campbell. Both players have expressed that they've at least thought about retirement, and when you start getting up there in age, you know, I mean, I can understand it. Playing in the NFL is definitely not easy. Now, he had 4 tackles for loss, 35 tackles, 0 sacks, 1 forced fumble. Williams, Campbell, hopefully both of those guys are back on the Ravens next season. Now, this is what this show's about. You guys telling me giving you some information, and then we go down in the comments, we interact with each other, and we actually have, you know, an adult conversation. So what position is the biggest need for the Baltimore Ravens as it stands right now? Let's continue to go through some of these other names here. Justin Houston, he's been an absolute monster as an edge rusher, even though he's getting up there in age, continues to be a solid guy. Deshaun Elliott, LJ Fort, Josh Bynes, Anthony Levine. Speaking of Josh Bynes, he's already come back and said that he would like to come back in Baltimore. You could probably get him on a good, cheap, veteran type of deal. He had himself a hell of a year, 76 tackles, 2 sacks, 6 tackles for a loss. And when you look at Bynes, I mean, the Baltimore Ravens are like literally the perfect fit for a player like him. Another guy who was actually pretty impressed with this season, Deshaun Elliott. 66.7% completion percentage against him, 23 tackles, 3 tackles for a loss, 1 pick, 2 pass breakups. Now, this is in only 6 games, but every single secondary player, every single cornerback for Baltimore was asked to do probably more than what they anticipated, simply because Marcus Peters tore his ACL right before the Monday Night Football game up against the Raiders to get the season started. Then you lost Marlon Humphrey. But Elliott, even though in his limited time, I actually was pretty impressed by him. What about Pernell McPhee, Justin Ellis, Justin Jelly, big hole defensive tackle there, Bradley Bozeman, Devonta Freeman, Latavius Murray. What's really going to be interesting out of these two running backs here, Freeman and Murray, is what exactly is going to be happening to J.K. Dobbins and all their other running backs that, you know, they were actually hoping could be out there. Gus Edwards, I drafted Gus Edwards in my family fantasy football league, and then that one, you know, really kind of bit me in the butt. Justice Hill's another guy. I mean, they're hoping that some of these other running backs can fill in, though I think everyone would agree Devonta Freeman actually, you know, played halfway decent. Now, here's a pretty interesting quote on the first 4 years with the Baltimore Ravens here from Bozeman. I've been very blessed. This place has been so amazing to me. Everyone involved from the ground up, from all of my teammates to the coaches to the fans, everyone, it's been a great place for me. So I'm just very grateful. Now, when you talk about his career path, you know, he was a 6th-round pick in the 2018 draft and has been, I'll say, one of the pictures of consistency. He had 1,125 snaps this season, played in 16 games, 3 sacks allowed, PFF overall grade of 73, 1 penalty against him. He's been a really, really solid dude, and these are the type of players where you're hoping you're able to go ahead and bring them back. Now, I want you guys to name a player, okay? Name a player you want the Ravens to go ahead and re-sign this offseason. When you have the amount of free agents that they do, obviously, it's going to be a little bit difficult, but that's kind of what happens when the salary cap went down. Good news, the salary cap's going up this offseason. So name a player you want the Ravens to re-sign this offseason. Now, I don't know about y'all. I love betting on the NFL. Heck, I've been betting on NBA. I even bet on Georgia to take down Alabama, and I'm feeling pretty darn good about it. Now, if you want to go ahead and bet on all the NFL playoff games, NFC, AFC, one place to do it and one place only. That's at chatsports.com/bet. I'm going to say it again because I think you were itching your you-know-what. chatsports.com/bet. It's right there. The link's down there below. One more time, chatsports.com/bet. Once you go to that link, use promo code CHAT125. It's going to get you 125% deposit bonus. So if you put down $100, get $125 for free to bet with. Put down $200, get $250 for free to bet with. You can actually put down $500, get $625 for free to bet with. It's the best damn deal on the internet. Did I mention? It's chatsports.com/bet. Let's go to some more free agents here for the Baltimore Ravens. Anthony Everett, David Sharp, Kevin Seymour, Eric Tomlinson, and then Chris Board. The one guy that I want to, you know, concentrate here on a little bit more is, you know, Anthony Everett, who had 54 tackles, 3 interceptions, 11 pass breakups, and just one player that, not that I didn't anticipate him playing at all, but nobody really thought that he would have the impact that he had. He was forced into a situation when Marcus Peters ended up going down. Sure, when you're the cornerback opposite side of Marlon Humphrey, you're going to get a lot of opportunities, and there was definitely at times that he got picked on, and there was definitely times where, you know, he rose to the occasion. But as it stands right now, here's what the Ravens' potential 2022 cornerbacks are looking like. Yeah, Marlon Humphrey, everyone anticipates him being back to, you know, a top five corner. What's Marcus Peters going to look like? He's getting up there in age, has definitely lost a step. And, you know, when you tear your ACL, I would imagine that's definitely going to be even more of a step back. And then Taven Young sitting there in the nickel. Now, more even players to go ahead and break down. Josh Johnson, he was realistically just brought in because of the injuries around the quarterback position. Chris Westry, Alakad, Nate McCray. I mean, again, more and more players to go ahead and break down. The next slate of names here, the one name, especially now, these are the exclusive rights free agents. So I wanted to write down some notes. That way you guys knew exactly what they were. So an exclusive right free agent is any player with fewer than 3 accrued seasons and is an expired contract. It is original team offers a 1-year contract at the league minimum based on his credited seasons. The player cannot negotiate with other teams. Now, the name that's on here that you guys probably really care about, maybe even Geno Stone, obviously it's Tyler Huntley. Tyler Huntley is a limited playing time this season. In the beginning, looked very, very good in my personal opinion, being able to throw the football, being able to run the ball. Now, he definitely struggled as the season went on, which is usually simply what happens. Why? Defensive coaches, other NFL head coaches, they start getting tape on you, and then they can see your strengths, they can see your weaknesses. But Tyler Huntley is definitely a player that I really anticipate the Baltimore Ravens to try to go ahead and bring back. Some more guys, Tyson Williams, Nick Moore, Aaron Crawford, and then Brandon Knight. Tyson Williams was a fun little story there for a little while, was a running back that was getting some work. But the fact that they went ahead and they brought in Lat Murray, the fact that they went ahead and brought in Devonta Freeman, tells me that Williams might not be back unless they try to get him on the practice squad. Now, I know a lot of free agents that we went ahead and went through there. If there's anybody that I mentioned that you're like, dude, they absolutely have to bring him back, go in the comments. Let us know, whether it's me, whether it's producer Jeremy. We're going to be keeping you guys up to date, everything going on around the Baltimore Ravens. So if you made it this far in the video, do me a favor, hit that sub button. And if you are one of our loyal subs, take that link that you see below, send it to some Raven fans, because the more subs we get, remember, the more videos we can do.